Francisco, which is a big box.
So about 12 hours ago, I had no idea what I was going to say. And we're down in the field earlier, and we're hanging out with all the incredible inductees that are going on with us. And Tony gives me a little nudge. She's like, I got to tell you something. I said, what's that? She's like, I was a freshman when you were a senior. And the first thing I remember was they told me that if I wanted to find best party to talk to Dean Frank. So I thought, honestly, I was like, well, you know, I left my mark on this school a little bit. So when Brett called me, I was probably the most shocked person because I thought maybe they were, they had some new type of category that was, that they were introducing to this. But, you know, this weekend has been absolutely incredible, from the golf tournament to the football game to this banquet. Great time for my family and my best friends, and it's something that I'll never forget. Now, I'm an incredibly lucky guy, to be honest with you. I've had an incredible life with baseball, and my first memory, and I'm not just calling him out because he's sitting there taking a video of me right now, but my very first memory of baseball was when I was 3 years old, and my mom had to run to the store. So I had a brother who's 10 years older than me. I was a pleasant surprise, my parents said. So he's out back. We had a little, we had a basketball court, a little slab of concrete in the backyard, and he was out there skateboarding. And you know, as a three-year-old who absolutely idolized his brother, I was bugging the ever-living crap out of him to try what he was doing. I said, I want to try that. I want to skateboard. So finally, he let me. And 2 steps later, I had a broken leg. And so my mom was home. So next thing you know, my first memory, I'm in a wheelchair at 3 years old, and my mom's in the backyard pitching me wiffle balls. And I'm taking batting practice with my leg stuck out, you know, take a swing. my second memory probably is when I was in eighth grade. The coach came up to me, took me aside, and said, we're gonna have a van come up that they're gonna pick you up about 45 minutes early from school, and you're gonna go up and play with the high school team. Now, that is an incredible recognition. I was just so happy to get out of school 45 minutes earlier. So a great moment turned unfortunately into a terrible moment, because that first game, I was playing third base. I'll never forget, we were warming up, I was turning double plays with the star quarterback that was a senior, and I made one throw, and immediately I knew that something went wrong, and I ended up tearing my labrum and my rotator cuff in the same throw. So a great moment, unfortunately, you know, turned into a bad moment, but it was a moment that just, you know, it wasn't a setback, it was just something that, hey, you know, things happen, we have to work through this. So my incredible parents looked into ways that I could rehab, and they found this unbelievable AAU program that I went to strictly just for rehab. And I met the coaches, I met the players, and the next thing you know, a fire was lit under me that I already had, because I had such a passion for the game of baseball that 260 days a year, 175 games a year, I was playing. I got the chance to travel the country. I went to Florida, San Diego, Mexico. I played in countless major league fields, and I saw so many great things. And the culmination of that was I got to go to the University of Notre Dame. There was a showcase out there. It was in front of all 32 major league teams, the top 100 colleges in the country. And I got to play baseball for 4 days. the memories that I have from being a part of that team were incredible. So I did what anybody would when they were senior year. I grabbed my parents and I said, I'm not going to play baseball anymore. So as incredible as they were, they sat me down and they were, you know, they were okay with it. I don't know what it was, I don't know what made me make that decision, but I decided that as a senior that I was going to play baseball. And it completely turned my, obviously, recruiting experience around. I had no idea where I was going and what I was doing. I think it was October of my senior year. Then we started touring colleges that I hadn't gone to. And I honestly didn't know what I was going to do. And then I got an incredibly timely phone call from the then assistant coach, JT, who was my head coach the entire time. He did a little ego stroking, which at the time was fantastic. Honestly, when I decided I wasn't going to play baseball anymore, I was all about the academics. I wanted something that I could go to and have a one-on-one, you know, relationship with professors and faculty and everything. So my brother went to Penn State, main campus. So, you know, I'm 8 years old. I go up there and I see a talent, you know, literally a talent. I couldn't handle this if I was him, you know. So I wanted something that really at the time was, as a student athlete, they put the student first. And when JT called me, it brought everything back, and I was like, not that I had forgotten about Stevenson and Village League, because I definitely had not, but it was like, wow, this is, at this point, once I decided I wasn't going to play anymore, this was the school that I really wanted to go to. I fell in love with the Stevenson campus, but just how picturesque it is as you drive up to it, and I was like, oh my God, this is it. And I'll never forget, I'm sitting in my shower, and I'm Mom! And of course, my amazing wife was sprinting in because she thinks something terrible is wrong. And I was like, I know where I'm going.